Hi friends, how are you all? I hope that you all are keeping fine. I'm also fine by the grace of our God. Today we are going to start a special topic of politics from the class 9, part 2, and a lesson 1 on democracy in the contemporary world. About that we started, maybe there are one episode we completed. This is the second episode. But today we are mainly going to deal with the military coup of 1973. Okay? And maybe the beginning of this lesson, and as an introductory part, comment that I have given a few information about these lessons. And we learned that one of the person, and his last message before his death, he has given one message. And about that Allende, we came to know that Salvador Allende, he given his own message. And almost of the rich people, even the church, was against of him. And he was selected or elected as a democratic system. And also, that was his governing style and everything entirely different with the rich people and the church. That purpose only. These people are against of him. And almost he was always dealing with others, giving the message to the, conveying his own message to the poor and the needy people. And the labor class people, because they are always maybe neglected on every area. That purposely, this Allende, after his election, is selected and he became the president. And then we can understand that he was always giving and cooperating with the labor class. That's the main reason for behind his death, that we understand that. And now we have to understand about the military coup of 1973. Military coup means that the dictatorship. Dictatorship means, you know, there are so many. Hitler, one of the examples of dictatorship. Military coup, one of the examples, we can understand that. Hitler, Saddam Hussein, these are the people we can understand that. They are just like dictators, okay. You know, just like the king. And whatever they deserve to do, they will do it. They never think about the, maybe the development, the welfare of the people. So, whatever coming in their own mind, they will do it. If they want to kill the millions of people, they will do it. That type of maybe the leadership as a governing system is called military coup, one of the military coup. So, so many examples we can see in the history. And now we are learning about the military coup of 1973 and after the death of the Allende and how he died, about the information I would like to give today. And here we can understand that on the morning of the 11th September 1973, okay, 11th September 1973, these days we can understand that. The defense was arrested by the military and military took over the seaport. This 73, almost the military there took over the seaport. And we are going to get the information that the defense minister was arrested by the military coup. Okay? And maybe the seaport, they always they came and they went under the control in 1973. After that, the defense minister was arrested. Then we can understand that the military commandant asked the president to resign. Okay, so you know that even his own Allende's, his own maybe the government, and the military commander was asking the Allende's that you are resign. Okay, because he became the Chile's president. He is elected by a democratic system, and even though all the laborers are labor class people, and maybe the neglected people are always being with him. And always, even Allende was giving very good message to the laborers class only. And this is the one of the reason problem for the rich and the maybe the rich people, and also this the feudal people, and also the church. They were against of this this Allende's system. That purposely they just want to maybe take away his life from him. And that purposely they came the coastal areas, and what they heard, they arrested the maybe the Allende. And after that, the military commander asked the president that you have to resign your job. And we are get the information that the Allende refused to resign or leave the country. Maybe these people were asking to leave the country and resign his own job. Okay, he became the president of the Chile, and he was asked by the military group that you have to resign your job. Okay, and Allende refused. That's one of the reason behind of his death. And here, very clearly said Allende refused to resign to leave the country, realizing the danger to the country and his life. He addressed the people through the radio. So the first episode we have we read one of the portion that the last message of the Allende that we read that, and he was addressing the laborers people. He said that maybe after the few months I will not be no more. Okay, I will be no more because there will be enough stars for his own death. He understood. Okay, and after that he has given his own message to the poor people, others the laborers, that we are getting the clear information from this textbook, and through the radio he has given the message. And after, because he refused to resign and he refused to maybe go away from the, leave the country, these the two reasons are there. Even the military group just arrested him, and this is the reason for the death of this Allende. And here I very clearly understand that then the military surrounded the president's house, started bombing it. Okay, you know, Allende was there, and maybe the surrounded by the Allende is maybe the residency. So many military group people are there, and he was asked, they are all asking them to resign the Allende and leave the country. But Allende refused. That purposefully they started the bomb his own residence. And what happened at a moment, a few minutes, we can understand that almost Allende and completely burned, and he became no more. So his death was taking place. Then the military surrounded the president's house and started bombing it. The president Allende died on the military attack. Okay. So the military people, the military coup attacked Allende, and he became no more. So that's a clear information we are getting from the textbook. The government elected by the people was overthrown by the military through the conspiracy and violence. And very clear information we are getting from this part is that the government is elected. You know, Allende's government was elected. Okay. Government was elected by, he is elected and selected by as a ruler. But you know, this Allende's rule, otherwise the government was elected by the people but was overthrown by the military coup. Okay, this he was elected at the same time elected by the people, but that's overthrown by the military coup. That's the understanding we are getting from this paragraph. Because he was elected, all the people are maybe they're happy with the, even the laborers are happy with the Allende. He was ruling very nicely, but the rich and the feudal people and also the church was against of him. That purposely there was a maybe after 1973, maybe they surrounded by his own house, his military group, asking to refuse the job, but he was refused. Resigned the job, he was refused. That purposely, and he was killed. Allende, he was no more right now. And you know that main thing we have to understand that the elected and Allende was killed by the, otherwise overthrown by the military coup. So we are learning about the military coup, and those people are doing such work. Okay, you know that how can people can trust on such a military coup? You have to think about that. How were the people of that country, if they actually, how they are able to cast their trust on the military coup? Because the military coup already killed Allende by throwing the bombs in his own residence, and the people are now scattered. They are never to cast their trust on the military coup. These are the situation came up. This is Chile. That's the information we are getting from this part. Now, then on the 11th September 1973, after the death of this Allende, what happened to Chile? So we have to learn something about this portions. A military coup general, Augusto Pinochet, otherwise Pinochet, led to the coup. You know that one of the military coup, maybe leader was there, general was there. His name is Augusto Pinochet. Military general. Okay, after the death of Allende, then 1973 itself, maybe Augusto Pinochet, otherwise Pinochet, he as a general of the military, he was selected. Okay, for the otherwise he was trying to start the ruling, and maybe that's Chile. And but the government of the United States of America was unhappy with the Allende's rule. Okay, you know that. Here we can understand that the government of United States of Augusto, America, was unhappy with the this rule. And Pinochet became the president of the country and ruled for next 17 years. Okay. Now, after the death of Allende, he was ruling. He started ruled maybe the 17 years. Okay, total 17 years he ruled. And now the elected government power shifted to the military officers. You know that the government also there, military group also there. The both are maybe ruling over there. You know that the military group may be the his Augusto Pinochet, and he was the general of the general ministry, and 17 years he ruled. At the same time, the government also there, and also the military group also there. The both are there in the Chile. You can understand that. Or the Chile, these two different powers are there. Maybe the military group also there, at the same time, elected government also there. But Augusto Pinochet was ruling, and he was ruled nearby the 17 years. Now the elected government power shifted to the military offices. You know that the government was there, that power shifted to the now the military group, because now we can understand that almost all the power is given to the Pinochet. You understand what I am saying? Elected government was there, but now the ruled by the Augusto Pinochet, and almost all the rule which is maybe in the government that overthrow is given to the Pinochet. Now he ruled nearby the 17 years. They left to the country as they wish. You know that now if a democratic system that the people are there, those who are governing, they will think about the welfare of the people of their own country. For example, if Arande selected by the people, he will mainly look after the maybe the welfare of the their own country, Chile's people. If that purpose only, he never concentrated on the rich people, he never concentrated on the feudal people, but he was always concentrating. He wants to uplift even the poor, even the needy people, even labor class people. He wants to uplift, okay, Allende, because he was elected by the people only. As a democratic system, he was selected. That purpose only, he wants to uplift the people, that always the ordinary people, the labor class people, he wants to uplift. But these people, even the military group, they never thinking about the welfare of these poor people. He always concentrated the rich people, and whatever they want, as they like, they will do their own governing system. They are able to change whatever they want to do, they can do it, because they never want thinking about the even the labor class, maybe the poor class of the people in their own country. So, the 17 years, we can say that the military group, Augusto Pinochet, he ruled according to his own wish, according to his own desires. And here we are getting information that they led to the country as they wished, and no one can question them. You know that this military coup is no one is able to raise questions against him. Okay, this military coup, this is another specialty for these people. No one is able to raise question against their own ruling. Okay, because everybody, whatever they are doing, we have to be satisfied, we have to be there, we are unable to raise any question. But in democratic system, we can understand that if we are unhappy with the ruling, the rules and regulations of the government, we are able to raise our questions. But here, this military coup, nobody is there, even the Chile, nobody is able to raise the question against the Pinochet. That's one of the important things. We have to understand that. Then who like this type of systems? Then military group is there. As they lie, they are able to rule. According to their own desires, they will rule. If they want to kill someone, they will kill it. Nobody is able to raise the question against this Pinochet rule. That was the situation was there in Chile. Now, they look to the country as they wished. No one can question them. So their military dictatorship established in Chile. Because of that, through this way, the dictatorship or the military coup established in Chile. This is information. Allende was there. Allende was elected and elected by the people. And he was always concentrated on the poor people also, poor and needy. That was the problem for the rich people and maybe the feudal people and the church. And they were against of this Allende. And he was killed, bombed, his own residence. And he was killed. Then Augusto Pinochet came. He became the general of the military. And 17 years after, he ruled. And at the same time, we can understand that almost all the power which was the government that given to the maybe the Pinochet, and he ruled according to his own desires. And you know that here main thing we can understand that so the military dictatorship established these are the ways in Chile. Okay, you got it how maybe the Chile got up with the dictatorship and how that established the military coup in Chile. About that, we are getting the information from the 1973 onwards. So the Pinochet government tortured and killed several those supported and Allende and those who waited democracy. Okay, and another important, because I already informed you that this military coup people they will do as they like. Okay. The same way, here getting the information that the Viral Shah can be tortured and killed. Okay. And several those supported Alande. You know that in Chile itself, there are so many people, mainly we can understand that the poor people, supported by even Allende. Though the poor people, the lowest caste people, always supporting Allende, and they always wanted the democracy. That purpose only, this military group people try to find out those people, those who are supporting the Allende, those who are waiting for the democracy. These two different type of people, they find out that they killed. You understand what I'm saying? Because once they like, they will do it, military group people. That purpose only, even they find out the people, supported Allende, okay? Those people supported Allende and those people waiting for the democracy and maybe the Augusto Pinochet find out those people and kill. And General Alberto Bachelot of the Chilean Air Force and many other officers were refused to join the military coup. Now you can understand that because these people, the military coup people are dealing with the locals. Otherwise, locals of Chile, otherwise the lovers of the people indifferently. Okay, according to their own wish, according to their own desires. That purpose only, now the general, Alberto, one of the persons called Alberto. Bachelet, okay. And he also the military general. Okay, now in his own military coup and the military general is there, his name is Alberto Bachelet, and this person was unhappy with Pinochet. Okay, this military general was unhappy with Augusto Pinochet because what are the things that are done by this Pinochet was entirely different. He is not at all doing anything for the welfare of the Chile people. That purpose only, this man, that Alberto, Augusto, this Pinochet, that we are getting the information. And what happened? The General Bachelet's wife and daughter were put into prison and tortured. You know that this is not military coup. The military general, his name is Alberto Bachelet. He was against of this Pinochet. That purpose only, his wife and daughter also sentenced into the prison. Okay. That wife and the daughter caught by this Pinochet and put into the prison. And they were tortured. And more than 3,000 people, more than 3,000 people tortured, they were killed, okay. And you know that this Alberto Bachelet's wife and daughter also be tortured and they were put to the prisons. And why these are things that happened? Because her husband and the military general and Alberto Bachelet was unhappy with this Alberto Pinochet. This is one of the reasons. That purpose I said that this military coup people, they will do as they like. So, nobody is able to raise the question against those military coup. That purpose only, always people, they have to suffer. They have to tolerate everything, whatever the military is doing. Because nobody is able to raise the question against the military coup. That purpose only, this Alberto Bachelet, his wife, and also his daughter also put into the prison, sentenced into the prison. And you know that more than 3,000 people were killed. And mainly we can understand that the 3,000 people were killed, they might be a labor class. At the same time, they may be waiting for the longing to see the democracy. Those people always the followers of the Allende. Okay. They always waiting for the Allende and his system, the democratic system, that purposely those people, even more than 3,000 people were killed. And Alberto Bachelet and his wife and daughter also sentenced into the prison. Now, many of them are reported missing, as missing. And after that, so many people they caught and find out that they reported that they are missed. Okay, missing, okay. Because no one knows where they went. They just like disappeared. Okay, this system also happened. You know that disappear means these people, that the fellowship, the people may be killed. I think they find out the people and killed. That purposely they were missed. And you know that no one knows about what happened to them. And finally we can understand that no one knows what happened to them. Only the people understand that there are some people they missed. Reported that's missing. And you know, because of the military coup, and they established in Chile in 1973, and after that so many changes taken place in Chile. And the military coup, they decide, and whatever they do, whatever they want to do, they will do according to their own decisions. Okay. And whoever coming against of this system, they will be killed within days. That was the situation we can see in the 1973, the military coup, 1973. Okay, this is the topic. So, I hope that you understand about the information which I already explained to you through this topic. Today, I'm going to wind up for this classes for today. And we will come to the next topic by the next episode. And you go through the books. There are so many terminologies are there, maybe difficult for you. And read it carefully and find out the vocabularies and learn the meaning from the dictionaries and try to learn the complete lesson. Okay. Till then, okay, next class. I would like to give bye and see you in the next class. Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless you all.